The only reason why I could move to HDX was because of McDSP. I bought my HDX cards in January of 2012, and I put them in and out, when I was tracking, I had to take them out. When I was mixing, I could put them back in and stuff. So it became a bit of a time soak and just a really sort of an aggravation to me. So then eventually I stopped putting the HDX card in just because it was too much hassle every time. But when McDSP made their stuff AX and I tried it out and it was as sound as fantastic as it did, then that enabled me to keep the same workflow I always had. So then that's when the HDX card went into the system and stayed, because I had enough of the proper plugins I needed to be able to mix as I go. I always notice the song and singer first, because that's what we're doing this for. We're here to make music. I mean, really, engineering, production, all the technical knowledge that I've acquired has really been just to help me make music. I'm one of the guys that came from the musician place, from being in a band and, you know, failing that and graduating, but, you know, getting some skills. So anytime I hear anything, I always hear the song and then usually I hear the singer in the song, and then usually how I could have done it better. Or not necessarily better, but how I would have done it, or how I could make it better. All the, you know, the stuff I did with Mud, I'm really proud of, because it's just great. I mean, it's just, you know, produced really well, and of course, and, you know, that was sort of my first good sounding, really good sounding things that I'd ever done. So for me, it's special. The more recent stuff that I've done, the In This Moment album, Blood, I mean, that's, I think, artistically one of the best things that the band and I have done. So I'm really proud of that. I think it really sounds great. And Maria is such a great singer. The Five Finger Death Punch stuff, I mean, I'm really proud of it all. I've been really lucky to not take projects that I'm not going to be proud of. There's been very few where at the end of it I'm going, oh, you don't have to put my name on that if you don't want to. You can just say you produced it yourself. I mean, I've been very lucky that I've been happy with the people I've worked with, and I've repeatedly worked with them. Like In This Moment, that was the third record I did with them. I'm working on the third one on Five Finger now, so I did two with Ozzy. I'm actually, you know, the Ozzy stuff I'm actually really proud of too. I mean, Ozzy's a great guy and a great singer, and obviously, and, you know, I was probably the weak link in that chain, but, you know, I did the best that I could, and I listen to it now and I still really enjoy it, and I think that we did some great work. Well, the favorites change day to day depending on what I'm working on. My favorite right now would be the Futz Box. Because, you know, before the Futz Box, I was having to use a lot of plugins to get that effect. And so it would take me quite a while to audition and try a whole bunch of things. I'd have to, you know, lo-fi it and, you know, bit crush it and then distort it and then EQ it again. And, you know, only to come up with one sound. And then I got to try another sound because I'm never satisfied with the first sound. So with Futz Box, I'm actually able to flick through a bunch of presets quite fast, drastically different ones, and, you know, if there's 50 sounds, I can flick through to find one, then I can tailor that one around what I need. So it's again, for me, it's about finding faster tools of doing the same thing or doing the better things. And so that's been, I just came up with the best lo-fi drum sound I ever have in my life, so I'm really excited about that. I'm sure you'll be hearing that on future records. Obviously, the first thing is sound. I can, you know, crank a starting block and plug in if it's gonna sound good. It doesn't matter how long it takes, but it has to sound good. So the first box to be checked off is, does a McDSP plug-in sound good? And the answer is yes. Second thing is ease of use. How fast can I get it to sound good? Records are taking less time, less money for budgets, all those kind of things. I got to be able to get it done fast. So the user interface is extremely important. And then of course the extra features. So I don't want a copy of an LA-2A again. I want to find a new kind of plugin. I want to find something that has new features, something that gives me an edge over some other audio guy. I just don't want to just be trying to be digital, but make it just analog tools. You know, we have analog tools. I can send it to my 1176, and if I want an 1176. So I'm really interested in companies that have extra features, and like the bite, you know, control on the compressor. I mean, that's fantastic. Yeah, I'd say it has to be about, not always about talent. I mean, people think that all the people doing at the top of rungs of that ladder are this wonderful bunch of talented people, and in most cases they are. But I think that the thing that goes along with that talent is just hard work. So I would say, you know, my only advice is to work as hard as you can and keep an open mind and be able to roll with the punches. I'm not here to make records for me. I'm here to make records or CDs or MP3s, whatever you want to call it, for the artists I work with. I'm here to help them succeed in their goals. And I think that's the other thing. If people want to be like me, they have to realize that you're there to help artists, other artists, make music. You know, one day maybe I'll have a solo album. Probably not. Probably never. Because you wouldn't want to hear me sing, but at this point, you know, roll with the punches, have a good attitude every day when you wake up, and expect nothing.